going on, everybody, and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video we are going to be doing another recreation, and this one I was kind of excited about because I didn't know what I was going to do. So today, as you can see by the title of this video, we're going to be recreating an IGTV makeup look by Rushana Isaacs. So I found this cute little lilac smoky eye because I personally have not done a smoky eye in a long time, so I felt like now was a better time as any. And it's also like a lilac pastely purple. I also do not tend to reach for like pastel colors because I just feel like I can never get them right, but we're going to try that today. Another interesting thing is Rushana, if you don't watch her videos, does the soap brow technique which I found that could be quite interesting. So in the midst of this whole lockdown mess, I managed to get my hands on some pure soap. And yeah, we're just gonna give it a try. This is all about having some fun and just kind of experimenting with how people do their makeup. If you want to see how this look turned out, please do give this video a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, head down, hit that subscribe button, and let's just get into the video really. Okay, so Rushana already applied a primer, so we're just going to do that. I am going to use my Kiki Beauty Makeup Ready primer because my skin tends to agree more with a moisturizing primer. So I normally do my brows and eyes first and leave the base for last. So it's going to be really interesting to continue my makeup with just primer on, because I think she doesn't put her foundation on next. I'm now going to go ahead and apply my eyeshadow base. Yep, I was right. We're going straight into eyeshadow. So just as the previous recreation video, I don't have all or if some of the products that Rushana is using, so I'm just gonna kind of sub them out with some very similar products that can get the job done. So I'm gonna use the Revlon Candid Concealer in the shade Biscuit. This is quite a light concealer for me, so I feel like it could be like a really nice eyeshadow base. I don't use eyeshadow bases because for me concealers have always worked, so yeah. But I really do want to get my hands on the P. Louise one, like I'm super interested.
Because I'm using quite a light shade on my lid, I am going to pack this eyeshadow base on.
So I'm trying to be like really careful around the brow area, not to go in too much. Okay, once that is done, she goes in with a pastel purple color from the Jeffree Star Bloodlust palette, I think it's called. I don't have that palette, and I honestly don't think I would buy that palette just because I don't think I would reach for it as much. And I'm not going to get my value for money, but I do want to own like a Jeffree Star palette. I just haven't found one that's like called my name yet. But to dupe that, I'm going to go in with the BH Cosmetics Shinexo palette. This is a much more affordable option if you're looking for one. And I'm going to use the shade Lover, which is this one right here. It's pretty similar to the color that she's using. Then she goes in with a flat, more kind of packing brush and then blends it out. So I'm just going to use one brush for both things. It is a kind of fluffy blending brush, but it is quite slanted on one side, so it allows you to pack and blend at the same time.
Okay, so I just packed that color on. I'm now going to use my blending brush and I'm just going to blend the shade into the crease.
It's amazing what you can do with one color and a really good brush, because even looking at Rushana's look as well as mine, it looks like we've used more than one color just to kind of get the job done, which looks really, really cool. Okay, then she goes in with lashes. So I'm gonna do the same with my similar lashes. These are Eyelash Boutique in the style Dolce 5, I think. Yeah, I feel like it's Dolce 5. And I'm actually gonna apply this with a recent kind of technique that I learned, which is actually just applying lash glue to your lash line like this.
I'm just going to run my lash through.
And then you just go in with your lash. I learned this in my previous video when I was testing out TikTok hacks. So if you missed that, definitely give it a try. So the reason why I didn't do the whole lash thing on the back of my hand like Krishana did, it's because my lash glue is on an applicator and I can't like tip it out. It's not possible because I think hers is in a tube. So yeah, that I think is the only thing that I changed. But other than that, it looks pretty cool, man. Okay, so she did her whole soap brow action while she waited for her lash glue to dry. Mine did not have to, I didn't have to wait basically. So we're gonna do the soap brows right now. As I said, I've never done the soap brow technique, so please do not come for me. Please, I'm trying. I did go back and look for one of her brow tutorial things that I saw, I think a while back. So I just got the pure soap. So all you need is some setting spray. And then I'm going in with a disposable spoolie just because I don't want to ruin mine. And then you just basically like load the spoolie. That's like how I've seen it. I know a couple of people do use this technique. It seems to work for them. I feel like I have too many brow hairs for this. Then I'm just going to brush it up, up, as high as I can get it. My brows are trimmed in such a way that I can do my brow style. This is definitely something new. I'm just going in with a cotton pad and some micellar water because I think I went a little bit like haywire with the soap. But I think I actually got it right this time. Hey! Shout out to Roshana. That routine actually helped me even. Okay, then she goes in with foundation. Wait, are we not gonna fill in the brows like at all? Like, that's pretty hectic. I have a scar on my eyebrow, right? So it means that it's not full. Man, foundation, I'm gonna go in with my Maybelline Fit Me foundation in the shade Golden Caramel. So I just like to pop it on the back of my hand and then use it this way. I don't like to use it from the tube, and I'm just gonna blend that through. I don't really wear a lot of foundation because I love to like have my freckles on display. To cream contour and highlight slash conceal, she uses the MAC concealers. I'm going to go in with the more affordable version, the Revlon Candid concealers. My concealer is in the shade Biscuit, the one I use for my eyes, and the contour slash bronze is in the shade Hazelnut. She first does the highlighting aspect and then the contour, and then she does this thing. Which is interesting because I do it the opposite way, because I feel like I can sometimes go overboard with my contour, then I can always just clean it up with concealer. Then I'm going to go into the other shade. Cream bronzers and contours I find are so, they're more natural in a way, because it looks like it's blending with your concealer. And if you blend it into your hairline, it looks even. All right, then I'm gonna add the same purple as well underneath my eye. I'm tapping every freaking bit of excess on because there's no powder there. I'm very nervous. All right, then we're gonna go in with mascara. Then for highlight, I am going to use the Cookie Highlighter by Benefit. At this point, I just have one question. Where's the powder? Because I'm only allowed to do whatever she says or whatever she shows. Oh, please tell me you're gonna put powder on your Roshana, please. Then we're gonna bronze. I'm gonna go in with Hoola by Benefit as well. This will always be like a really, really nice, easy and effortless choice. For blush, I'm going to be using the blush by Essence. Then for lips, I'm going to go in with MAC Taupe. It's a pretty similar, but this is just a little bit darker. I've come to terms that we're probably not going to do powder. I'm really heartbroken. Okay, then she goes in with a gloss. I do not own a gloss. Like, I just don't like them, okay? So I'm gonna go in with this Kiki Beauty Makeup Ready Rose Wax Lip Balm. It's super, like, it's glossy, but it's a lip balm. So hopefully it does something. So I'm just gonna apply some onto my finger and hopefully it'll do what we need it to do. Yeah, that looks glossy. Oh my word. The lighting is ever changing. I'm so sorry, guys. But thank you guys so much for watching. I will leave a link down below to her Instagram. You guys can check her out if you haven't already. I feel like everybody has. And yeah, she posts, like, she's pretty consistent with tutorials if you guys want to check it out. And she has a really cool back to basics series that can, like, teach you all the little aspects if you're new to makeup, which I definitely recommend checking out. But yeah, I will see you guys next week with another video. Let me know down below whose recreations you want to see next. I have some pretty interesting ones coming up. Have a wonderful day, night, evening, wherever you are. Stay safe, stay healthy, and I'll see you next time. Bye.